third down, a short pitch. Is that the dumbest question you've ever heard?
Well, no, it's not. The reason I'm laughing about that is we had not worked that play. And the information that came from me from the booth was a different personnel grouping that was actually in the game. And I made the call when they lined up. I thought to myself, oh boy, we're screwed right here. And Kaiser makes the play. And so we were, that was not the intentional call for that play, but it worked out.
What group did you think was out there?
11 personnel. And they were on third and short. They've been 11 running 33 read zone a bunch. So we had a special call for that. I call it, they come out in 12. Bunch it up and they run that little flick play, and thank goodness Kaiser's a football player and he made me look like a very smart coach right there.
Did they have something that cue he's supposed to read that he?
Well, he has the back anyway, so okay. He just did his job. But
so as long as he doesn't come crashing down.
Yes.
Okay.
It's only a pass back play to Hill. I mean, that comes, you know, obviously you don't practice against that, I assume.
What we do, every week we go through a set of trick plays of what they've shown, and we'll go back 2-3 years and dig in the film, and they've never really shown that. They had it with Boykin. It wasn't like that. It was more of a double pass off.
Yeah,
of it.
I mean, that was pretty good play. I mean, not even speaking about the way it executed, just the concept of it.
Well, you have to give them credit. The two times that they got us with trick plays were crucial points in the game,
right.
And they both worked. If those both backfire and they lose the game because of those,
calling them a dummy. Yeah.
So, but you got to give them credit. They executed. What we did bad, we had a guy or two get out of position, and then we missed a couple of tackles down the sideline.
And David missed the tackle. Your success over the years, or the last 3 years anyway, with the Texas Tech offense, I mean, is that, let me ask you first, Dana's got good knowledge of that. Do you get any input from Dana at all on what they do, and also why does your scheme seem to fit that?
Well, I think of what they do, the way that they're built is they were four wide, throw it, where we can match up with five DBs and doing some different things. I think that's what we're built for, being that Spurs, that hybrid guy for us, the nickel, whatever you really want to call him. I think that it allows us to play coverage, to be more aggressive. And so that's part of it. I think the other part of it is what we were 2 to 3 years ago offensively was almost what they were. I mean, we run the ball more, which they're starting to run the ball more now.
I'm going to see how that changes.
So it changes a little bit because you have to be leery of when to get after this quarterback and when to drop eight deep into coverage and do some different things and take away some things, because now you're opening up run lanes. So you have to be careful. They're different now, more different now than they've ever been, just because they're running a tight lane.
Apparently, while some of the lower teams in the league seem to be coming up, I mean, makes it. I mean, every week now it seems like it's a challenge, and maybe even a different challenge where before they were a lot alike.
Yeah, everybody's a little different now, and even when you think of a Kansas team that we've already played, they're different with Meacham now than they've ever been. So it's just difficult week to week to get ready for these high powered offenses. Getting 600-700 yards and 60 points, it's difficult. And obviously, people are going to get yards. They're going to do some things. But what we have to do is limit big plays. And we still have not been able to do that this year. And that's the frustrating thing.
Tony, the complexities of their running game, I know when the Air Raid really started to try to establish the run game, it was pretty base stuff. How complex can they get, or do they get, trying to establish that there?
Yeah, they'll do a good job. They run split zone. They'll run some tug sweep. They'll do some different things that we haven't seen yet. Split zone, obviously, everybody in our league runs it. But the tug is different for us. We haven't seen that this year. They'll run the quarterback, not much, but mm-hmm. he's a threat to pull it and do some things. So you always have to account for that part of it. And they're a zone stretch team. So
yeah,
it's stuff that we've seen, but their backs are a little different. They have big backs, they have little backs, and they use them all.
How do you address trying to get off blocks a little bit more and just make plays? Were you comfortable with that the last time, or would you like to see that improve a bit along the front?
Yeah, you always want to be better with it, but we practice it. We do it daily. That's part of our individual as linebackers, as D-line, as safeties. So, everybody needs to do a little better job of leveraging the football.